Hello students, so today's topic is circuit analysis using Laplace transform. As we previously discussed that the partial fractions will be used in solving the various numericals of Laplace transform. So when we talk about circuit analysis, basically it is divided into three parts. Firstly, you will be given the numericals in which there will be no initial condition. They are very simple to solve. Then the next one is with initial conditions in which you have to go for the Laplace transform with initial condition equations. Because in the first one, we ignore I0, V0 and all. But when we get the initial conditions, then we have to apply everything. And then it is a little bit more complex than the first case. And the last case is when steady state conditions are provided. So in this case, you have to first, using the steady state conditions, calculate your initial conditions and then apply your Laplace transform. So let's start with the very first part. That is, we will be solving the numericals today that will be without initial conditions. So in the next lecture, we will be going for our this part in which the initial conditions will be given. And the last one will be when the steady state conditions will be given. So here is the numerical. This is our question number one, in which you people are told that if switch S is closed at T equals to zero, then you have to calculate the resulting current IT, but using Laplace transform. So basically, when we talk about your various methods, the theorems can be applied, everything can be applied, but what we have found is that Laplace transform makes the numerical solving more simpler than the other ones. So let's start. The very first thing, whenever you are given with a closed loop, the first thing you will be applying is your KVL. And I hope everybody remembers KVL, otherwise you can just go to the KVL video and watch that lecture. So now we are going to write down the equation for the KVL. So here you are given with your 50 volts and that is switch is getting closed. So it will be IR plus L. Let me write it in terms of this only so that after that we can put the values. Let me change this to IR also. So it will be this thing. So now let's put the numerical values here. So it will be 2IT. L value is 1, so it will be simply di by dt. And the last one is 1 upon 0.5 it dt. Now you all know that 1 upon 0.5 is equal to 2. So I am going to replace here 0.5 with 2 so that we can easily apply our now Laplace transform. So here we go with your final equation on which we are going to apply our Laplace transform. Before applying the Laplace transform, you all must know that di by dt, the Laplace transform of di by dt is equal to s into is. This it will be converted to Laplace transform is in capital. And this d by dt is always, the derivative term is always replaced by a s. Similarly, whenever you have got an integral term like it dt, your this it will be replaced with capital is while the integral is 1 upon s. So this is how we are going to replace it. So let's apply Laplace transform on our this equation. So now our 2IT will become equal to 2IS as we discussed before, and our L di by dt will be equal to S into IS because L is 1 there, and our 2 integral of IT dt will become equal to 2IS upon S. Now on your right side, you have got 50, but because the switch is closed, so that gives us a step response and that becomes equal to 50 upon S, right? So now we have to take our this IS common. Let's take IS upon S common. And in the bracket, you will be having 2S S squared plus 2 equals to 50 upon S. Now your this s and this s cancels out, and now you will be writing the equation in terms of IES, because now after having it, we will be directly taking the Laplace inverse. So it is s square plus 2s plus 2. Now just check, you have to check here that can you apply a direct inverse Laplace transform formula? If no, then you have to transform it into such a form that you can apply the Laplace transform formula. So for here, we are going to apply our formula of sine omega t, that is omega upon s plus a square plus omega square will be equal to e raised to power minus a t sine omega t. So now we are going to convert our this thing into this form, right? So for that, I already told you that if you want it in that form, you have to add and subtract the half of the coefficient of s to your this equation. So your this equation will become equal to, now this s square plus 2s and this plus 1 will give you s plus 1 whole square, while your 2 minus 1 will give you 1. That can be written as 1 square also. So from here, you can just see that your a value is equal to 1, while your omega value is also equal to 1. So now we are directly going to apply it. So let me write it here. So it will be equal to 50 e raised to the power of minus t and sine t, because omega is 1 as well as a is 1. So this is the final value of our current IT that we needed to calculate. So this is a simple numerical in which a series connection is given. So let's come on to a parallel connection numerical. So now we come on to your numerical number 2. In this, you people are told to calculate VCT as well as ICT. That is the current in your this capacitor. So here you can see that it is given in terms of current. So now in the previous one, we applied KVL, and now we are going to apply our nodal analysis, right? So applying it here, or you can say just KCL here. So I will be applying in terms of KCL. I shouldn't say it like that. Okay. So now we are going to apply your KCL here. So the total current coming here on these nodes, we are going to just write down I will be equal to, because total voltage in every branch, because all are parallel, so every branch is VC. So it will be equal to VC upon R here. Same voltage exists in the second resistor, so that is also VC upon R. And last one, it will be C dVC by dt. And let me write my this VC in terms of t. Right? So here, just mind it that ICT and I both are different. They are not the same. So now directly we are going to add our these two terms, because these are same. So this becomes VCT by R. This becomes C dVC by dt. And now we are going to apply our Laplace transform. So applying the Laplace transform, because the switch is getting closed, so our this thing will become I upon S equals to 2. This will become capital VC. T will be going to S, and this will be equal to, now this is derivative term, so it will be written like this. Okay. So now we are going to take out our VC common and then write it equation again. So I'm only going to write this one here. So this becomes VCS taking common. So this will be equal to 2 upon R plus CS. So this is 2. So now this is equal to I upon S, and here I will be taking the LCM here. So this will be 2 plus RCS upon R. So let's take it to the other side. So this will be becoming equal to IR divided by S into RCS plus 2. Now you all know that we want to make it in terms of S plus A form. So for that, we have to take out the coefficient of S out. So the coefficient of S is RC. So let's take that RC out. So this becomes IR RC into S into S plus 2 upon RC. So now this R and R cancels out. So let me rub here and I will be carrying out the next calculation here only. Okay, so now we have our VCS equals to this thing. So VCS is equals to I upon C multiplied by 1 upon S into S plus 2 upon RC. So now you can easily see that now your this term contains two terms and they will be solved using your Laplace this partial fractions. So I will be only taking this forward and I will just keep on this here only. So this is going to give me the partial fractions of two constants A and B. And this will be equal to when I'm going to multiply there. So this will be equal to this thing. So now we have to calculate the value of A and B. So for that, I just told you to put the values there. So let's first put S equals to 0. When S will be equal to 0, so your B will be equal to 0 and it will be A into 2 upon RC. So this gives the value of A as RC upon 2. So keep it aside. Now you are going to calculate the value of B. For that, you are going to put S equals to minus 2 upon RC. So this is going to give you A 0 and your B will be equal to B into minus 2 upon RC. So this gives you B as minus RC upon 2. So now note down your this value also and put it in your this equation. So here, just don't forget that you have got this equation also, this value also. So here you go with VCS equals to I upon C multiplied by, now we are going to write over this equation. So this will give us RC by 2 divided by S minus RC by 2 divided by S plus 2 upon RC. So now we are directly going to go for your inverse Laplace transform. So before that, we can just take out RC by 2 out. So this will give us, we will be doing that after this step, RC by 2 common. So this will be 1 by S minus 1 upon S plus 2 upon RC. So your this C and C cancels out and now you are going to apply your inverse Laplace transform. So you all know that this becomes IR by 2. The inverse Laplace of 1 upon S will be 1 only, while the Laplace of this 1 upon S plus A will be e raised to the power of minus AT. So that gives you minus 2 upon RC multiplied by T. So this becomes the value of your VCT. Now, as you know that we just said that you have to calculate the value of current also. So for that, you have to apply that in your equation. That is, you have to go for your ICT will be equal to CD by DT of VCT. So now we are going to apply over this VCT here. So this gives me C multiplied by IR by 2 and then D by DT of 1 minus E minus 2 upon RCT. So now we are going to IRC by 2, take the derivative of this term. Derivative of constant is 0. So this gives me 0 minus the derivative of this is the power. that is minus 2 upon RC multiplied by E minus 2 upon RCT. Right? So now your this cancels out and you are going to get IRC by 2 multiplied by this becomes plus, so 2 upon RC into E raised to power minus 2 RC into T. So your this RC and RC cancels out, 2 and 2 cancels out, and you are left with I and E raised to power minus 2 RC by 2 into T. So that becomes your answer. So that's all for now. Okay, let's do one more numerical, a little bit complex one. So here you are given with that there is no initial condition or initial conditions are zero, and you have to calculate the value of I1t and I2t. So now there are two loops and it is a little bit lengthy one. So you have to understand it carefully. So because we are going to apply for the mesh analysis, so first we are going to go for your loop one. So for loop one, the equation will be 10 I1 plus di1 by dt, because the value of L is 1, plus 10 I1 minus I2, and that will be equal to 100. So here you are going to separate your I1 and I2 terms. So that will give you 10 I1 minus 10 I2, that is equals to 100. Now adding your this 10 I1 and this 10 I1 will give you 20 I1 plus di1 by dt minus 10 I2 equals to 100. Now you have to take the Laplace transform of your this equation, that is going to give you the value 20. It will simply get changed into your, here it is all it, this is also it. So it will change into I1s plus SI1s minus 10 I2s equals to 100 upon S. So now this is our equation number one. So just jot it down. Now we are going for your loop two equation. So for loop two, you are again going to write in the same pattern. Just keep this aside. So now we are going to come for your loop two equations. So for loop two, you are having L di 2 by dt plus R I 2t. Just keep on putting the notation t everywhere with I1 and I2, because they are going to be changed by the Laplace transform. So I2t minus I1t equals to zero, because no voltage source is there. So the value of L is 1, the value of R is 10. So I will just be putting the values here only. So here already I have put it. So now we will be separating them. So it will be 10 I2T. So these both will get added up and it will give us 20 I2T. So let's write down the values. So now we are going to have the Laplace transform of our this equation. As I told you earlier also, your this I1T will just become equal to capital I1S. Then will be your 20 I2S, and then it will be converted to S into I2S. So now this is our equation number two. Now we are going to write down the both equation and then calculate the value of our I1 and I2. So you all know the Cramer's rule, how we do it. So we can directly apply that, because that makes such equations simpler to calculate the value of I1. So I'm just going to give you a basic idea how you are going to calculate it. It will be delta 1 upon delta. While you remove your this for delta 1, you remove your first column with the constant terms that were on your left-hand side. That was your 100 at one side and 0 at one side will be replaced here. So similarly, when you are going to calculate the value of your I2S, that will be equal to delta 2 upon delta. Then your second column will be replaced by 100 and 0. So let's do it. so that you can be familiar with your this thing. So let me just write down the value of delta 1 here. So your delta 1 will be equal to 100 upon s, 0 here, minus 10. These are the values of I2, the coefficients of I2, and s plus 20 here. So this is my delta 1, and the determinant will give me 100 upon s into s plus 20. So similarly, we are going to calculate the value of our delta. So the value of delta is coming out to be s plus, that is the actual determinant with your I1 and I2 coefficients here. So it is coming out to be this one. And the determinant is s plus 20 square minus 100. That is going to give you s square plus 40s plus 300. This you can further factorize into s plus 10 into s plus 30. So we will be using this thing for your partial fractions. So I will be solving for your I1s and you will be solving for, this will be your homework to solve for your value of I2s, right? So I will just write down the value of I2, delta 2. So delta 2, you will be shifting it here, and delta 1, this will remain same. So for delta 2, you will be just writing this column as such, that will become s plus 20 minus 10 here in the first column, but the second column will be replaced by 100 by s and 0 here. So the determinant of your delta 2 will be equal to 1000 upon s. So let's find out the value of your I1t. So now you have seen that it will be equal to I1s will be equal to delta 1. So delta 1 was 100 upon s into s plus 20. And the value of your delta was s plus 10 into s plus 30. So again, you have to go for your partial fractions. So let's solve your this portion. So your this thing will be equal to, there are three factors, a upon s plus b upon s plus 10 and c upon s plus 30. So now you need to calculate the value of, this will be equal to now this whole thing here. So further, it will be 100 into s plus 20 will be equal to a into, so you have taken it to the other side and then you have to multiply them. The common factor will be cancelled out and you will be left with the others that are not in the denominator of that particular value. So now we are going to apply the very first thing to calculate the value of a, s equals to 0. So when you are going to put s equals to 0, put here also, s equal to 0 here also, here also, here also, and here also. So that will make b and c term equal to 0, while your a will be giving you the value. So now applying this, you will be getting your 2000 equals to 300a, rest all the terms are 0. So that will give you the value of a equals to 2000 by 300 as 20 by 3. Similarly, you will be going for your next value as s equals to minus 10. So this will give you 1000 equals to 0 minus 200b plus 0. That will be b minus 1000 divided by 200. That is going to give you the value of minus 5. Similarly, you are going to apply s equals to minus 30 in the equation. That will give you minus 1000, 0 everywhere, but 600 c here. So this will give you the value of c as minus 1000 upon 600. So that is give you the value of minus 5 upon 3. So now you have to put all these ABC values here. So just rub out here and let's replace them with ABC. So because we have to take the Laplace inverse also. So the value of A will be 20 by 3 by S. B is minus 5 upon S plus 10. And C is also minus 5 by 3 upon S plus 30. So they are directly inverse Laplace transform can be applied. So that will give me, this was the value of I1s. So after applying your inverse Laplace, this will become equal to I1t. So 1 upon s will be as good as 1. this will be equal to e raised to power of minus 8t, where a is equals to 10. And this will again be equal to e raised to power minus 8t, where a is equals to minus 30. So this is your amperes, and this is your answer for I1t. So I2t, you are going to calculate yourself. If there is any problem, just leave a message. Thank you so much.